Hello and welcome to Let's Chat. Now, on this show, one of the things I try to do is I try to keep it like a vlog, just me talking to a camera in a lighthearted manner. But one of my objectives is to actually make it educational as well. So today, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to ramble a little about one of the websites that I personally use a lot as a source, and just some discussions as to whether its use is good, as well as what sort of precautions we need to take before actually making use of this site. Now, what site am I talking about? Well, I'm of course speaking of Wikipedia. So what we're gonna do today is we're gonna try and discuss what it means to have a crowdsourced encyclopedia, what are some of its pros and cons, as well as what we can do to actually make our Wikipedia experience as good as it can be. Hopefully, this will be useful to you in a sense that, well, you can actually get a grasp of why some people are criticizing it pretty badly. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna start off by discussing some of the common criticisms of this platform. So here's the deal. The problem with Wikipedia is the fact that anyone with a computer can actually edit the pages. Yes, anyone from you to me to any old troll on the internet. What this of course means is that Wikipedia pages are open to vandalism. And the fact of the matter is, vandalism does actually happen. From extremely blatant things like completely wiping out an article or replacing certain words with swear words, well, that happens all the time. But vandalism could also be a lot more subtle. For example, I could go into a page and start just tweaking the numbers or the facts, and well, that will be harder to spot. And that's just vandalism, that's just things done in malicious intent. Even good faith information could possibly be wrong or at least dubious in some way. Essentially, the entire case against Wikipedia is in the fact that it is not reliable because, well, the information comes from basically everyone. However, here's how I see things. Now, with regard to blatant vandalism, well, like I said, it happens all the time, but safeguards are actually there to prevent them from actually sticking around for very long. A large number of volunteers, which incidentally you can join at any time, will actually look through all the recent edits and revert any that is blatantly just vandalism. That is the reason why you don't actually see vandalism very often, at least not in my experience, and I use Wikipedia a lot. It's extremely easy to spot and revert when people try to blank out pages or try to add swear words, and in fact, some users even bring in bots to make this process easier. That is the reason why major vandalism will not hang around for very long. With regard to the actual quality of information involved, Wikipedia actually demands that, well, facts quoted should actually be sourced. What this means is, well, you cannot just say something is a particular way, you are supposed to actually find some kind of reliable source and back up your statement. When this isn't the case, other editors can actually come along to flag out pieces of dubious data. This, of course, manifests a lot of the time in this little tag that says citation needed. The whole idea is, if somebody comes along and sees a statement that doesn't look quite right and does not have a source, they can actually demand for a source. So you will see, when reading the page, you will see the citation needed tag. You can even flag to say that a particular source seems flawed or not reliable for one reason or another, and in that way, if any piece of information shown has the possibility of being wrong, chances are somebody has actually flagged it out. So you get to see it and you get to take note of the fact. Really, here's how I see things. People from all walks of life get to edit Wikipedia, and many of them do. Now, this might seem like you get a huge variety of differing opinions on things, but as a matter of fact, most of the time, this is how you get things to average out. That is not to say things like edit wars don't happen, that is, people constantly trying to override each other, but even then, Wikipedia has its policies and methods to prevent things from going too bad. However, it is still important to understand that because this is the nature of a Wikipedia article, you have to take certain precautions when actually using it as a source. It is important to not see a Wikipedia article as the be-all and all of a particular subject. Instead, treat it as a starting point, just a very basic summary of all the facts relevant to a particular matter, which will actually help you in doing further research. Be wary when, well, statements are made without sources, and even when there are sources, you can actually pop down to the actual source itself to take a look at basically the nature of the page to just assess to see whether or not you think the source is trustworthy. Don't stop your learning there either. Move on and try to look for more on the topic from other places. Personally, I really like Wikipedia, because after all, it is a free and widely accessible source of information. It also exceeds traditional encyclopedias in a very significant manner, in the fact that, chances are, whatever it is you're looking for, you will find something about it on Wikipedia. Now, just as a footnote, oftentimes in an educational context, students are barred from actually citing Wikipedia pages as a source. Now, this is very much understandable. In and of itself, a Wikipedia page is not a rigorous source. It is not the result of one person's research. Instead, it is more of a second-hand retelling of information from a variety of sources. So, well, it's understandable that you should not be actually directly citing a Wikipedia article. Having said that, it doesn't mean that Wikipedia is useless in an academic context. Instead, treat it as a contents page of sources that you can actually refer to. Throughout a Wikipedia article, you see citations from various sources. And if you were to actually scroll down to the very end, you'll realize that a number of references tend to be made to external sources. As a student, you can actually pop over to those sources and refer to them to see if they give you information that you can cite directly. So here's your final takeaway. Personally, I don't think there is a need to actually be afraid or avoid Wikipedia as a source of information. Understand that Wikipedia articles in and of themselves are not actually very rigorous or very extremely complete. So use them to actually give you a general picture on any subject and treat it as a starting point for you to do even further research. When used with understanding, Wikipedia is extremely useful and can give you very quick insight into subjects that you've never even thought of before. So yeah, that basically wraps it up for this episode. Hopefully this gives you some insight into what Wikipedia is and what part it has to play in our lives. Like I said, and I strongly believe in this, don't shy away from Wikipedia as a source. It still is very useful. Well, thank you very much for watching this episode of Let's Chat. Until next time, you're watching 0612 TV. Hello, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget I appreciate every like, favorite, and comment you give me. If you'd like to see more from me in the future, don't forget to subscribe. For more updates outside of YouTube, do follow my official Twitter account at 0612 TV. And if you'd like to see more of my work, you can also check out my About Me page. Once again, thank you very much for watching, and until next time, you're watching 0612 TV.